I wanted to walk out like a princess.
You all know my mantra. It's all about the bride. But now, we're gonna celebrate the men who invade the bridal salon.
I think you're smoking.
I'm proof that men in the bridal world have a lot to say. But this fashionista wins the prize for the most outspoken.
My name is Laura Rothrock. My fiancé, Joel, he was in Iraq for about 8 months. Being apart definitely brought us closer.
Bride Laura has brought three friends, but there's one person she knows will dominate the appointment.
Yes.
Okay. This is Rob.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
I am a runway buyer for a global luxury fashion brand. I should be the best at buying something for one of my best friends.
The bride has asked for a lace vintage feel, but Rob's less than impressed.
Are those Halloween costumes that you just put in?
I like the lace.
The more and more I look at it, I actually hate it. I hate lace. Just makes it look dated and not sexy. Yeah, no, I hate it. Take it off. It's gross.
Even guys get carried away with their fashion opinions. But remember, step back and let the bride speak first.
Feeling the bride is going down the wrong road, fashionista Rob makes his suggestions.
I just asked for a basic sheath dress reminiscent of lingerie.
You don't like it? You're the one that wanted this.
No. It definitely did not fit her at all. It was unforgiving.
You can see her lungs going in and out, right? I just want something more vintage looking.
Okay, get it off.
No matter how seriously you take your fashion, you should always be open to the bride's sense of style.
Staying true to her vision, things start to look up for Laura.
I like this one.
Yeah,
I love it.
Too.
I like the back.
Yeah.
I love this.
It's gorgeous.
I really do.
It changed my whole perception of what lace looks like on a bride.
This is it.
This is the dress?
Yeah.
Now, you expect a style guru to be opinionated, but it's a real surprise when dads are the most vocal ones in the group.
Hi, how are you? I'm Jessica.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Sarah Baum. My fiancé is with me, Giovanni.
But there's another man here with just as much influence on the bride.
Growing up, my mom moved to Florida when I was young, so my dad has been my mom also, so that's why it's really important for him to be here.
And dad has very set ideas on how his daughter should look.
Nothing big on the bottom, and I don't like that sparkly stuff, or the big flowers, I don't like that either.
The bride thinks she knows who the first dress will please.
I think my dad's gonna like the dress.
No, yeah, it's too long. Yeah, I don't know, where am I gonna walk next to you? I'm gonna fall.
I love how Jack thinks this dress is all about him. But dads, the only thing you need to worry about is your daughter's happiness.
Will dress number two do better?
I just feel perfect. I feel like there's no other gown that I should be wearing. What do we think?
Can you give me a second? Do I have to make a decision right now?
I want Dad to come up here, since you said you think you...
Hey, what do you think?
I think this one might be it.
This is the dress that I could tell by her face that she wants to wear down the aisle. Okay, but you look beautiful.
Thank you. I think this is the first time that he really realized that I'm getting married and there's a new man in my life. Finding the dress that my dad loves, I didn't think this was gonna happen.
So is this your dress?
Yes.
Yay!
A dedicated dad is rarely a bad thing, but a bunch of clueless guys, now that could be a real struggle.
Natalie?
Yes.
Hi.
My name is Natalie. My fiance, Adam, and I met about 3 years ago. I'm convinced that nobody in the world loves each other as much as we do.
So who do you have here today?
This is my fiance, my man of honor, bridesmaid, Trish, and Justin is our officiant.
But the guys soon admit they're out of their element.
Are we allowed to touch dresses? I don't know.
I have no knowledge of wedding dresses, really.
I'm not into the whole dress thing, but there's a lot of them here.
As a guy, coming into Kleinfeld is probably one of the most frightening experiences of my life.
Dress number one has the bride feeling hopeful.
I think it's a beautiful dress. I love the sheer overlay.
So what do you think?
I don't think I could marry her with this dress on. The dress looks terrible.
You don't like the dress?
Really?
I don't like it at all.
Let's go back there and punch that dress.
Boys will be boys, But too much criticism, now that could lead to disaster.
Natalie tries again with dress number two.
Ooh, okay, I like that
now
one.
Now we're talking.
Really?
Absolutely.
Right? Okay.
Yep.
That's a wedding dress.
Yes. Yep.
I guess I feel like a bride.
I love it. It is her wedding dress. It made me excited to watch her walk down the aisle and say I do.
Are you now saying yes to the dress?
Yes.
Group hug.
Terrible group hugs.
Thank you.
It's rare to see a brother shop with a bride. So when twin guys arrive in the store, it's twice as nice or double the trouble.
My name is Christy, and my fiance's name is BJ Pandit. He is my best friend. I brought my two younger twin brothers, and they're my men of honor.
But right off the bat, Christy and her brothers are on different pages.
I like ball gowns.
I'm not a fan of the ball gown dress. She needs to have something that fits her body very well.
So you want something that's sexy and over the top.
Show off her features. Yeah.
Dress number one has Christy excited.
I like it.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
I don't like the feathers. I don't like feathers at all. Feathers look like if she was wearing a chicken. It needs to be a different material than that. We were just like, please put that back. It's a no.
Even the most unlikely guys can become fashion police in the bridal salon. But they should try to add some words of encouragement, too.
The brothers have chosen dresses with more va-va-voom, but Christy has her reservations.
I think my main concern with this finding one that is a higher neckline on me, just because I have a scar from a heart surgery that I had when I was younger. I think this is gonna be their favorite. It's not what I picture. No.
Why would it happen? What do you think?
Christy, it looks so good. Words can't describe it. The dress looks so good.
I'm just not used to having other people see the scar. I just have to see if I can get used to the neckline. I've never worn a neckline like that before.
Christy, come on.
When we saw the final dress, we were like, you look absolutely beautiful. Yeah. Nobody's gonna look at you differently in that dress, and you just need to know that.
You gotta love these two for only seeing their sister's beauty and not her scar. But if the bride doesn't feel the same way, no amount of flattery is gonna make her love the dress.
With the twins unable to convince Christy, this bride goes home empty-handed.
Now, those boys wish the bride hadn't held back. But when it's dad who's having second thoughts, it's a whole different ballgame.
My name is Kimberly Hoffman. My fiance's name is Toby. He looks like Derek Jeter, so I feel like very lucky.
What do we have here?
Bride Kim's brought the family, including dad, who she wouldn't dream of leaving behind.
A lot of people were asking me, they're like, you're gonna have your father there? And I'm like, yeah.
The whole family have always been together on everything, and that's the way we operate.
But when Kim finds a dress that could be the one...
I absolutely love it.
Dad puts on the brakes.
Sure, you should take the time to think about it, you know?
No, but I love it.
I love Rolls Royces, too. We don't make decisions quickly in this family, and we think things out and we go over things.
With Kim happy, but Dad unsure, the family holds a conference.
Is it comfortable?
Very.
Is it something that you feel gorgeous in?
Yes.
But without dad's support, the bride starts to crack.
Are we having a moment?
Hey, when I cry.
Dads are cautious when it comes to family, but what's hard is realizing that their daughters are ready to make their own choices.
Do you love the dress?
I feel like I do love it.
It's your decision now. I thought she realized, you know, that was a dress she loved, and at that point, there wasn't much of a decision to make.
With dad on board, Kim's ready to make her announcement.
Is this your dress?
Y-E-S.